friends, my name is Nilesh. This video is about the rolling update strategy for Kubernetes. In this channel, earlier we had seen a couple of other strategies which are related to zero downtime deployment, like the blue-green deployment and canary deployment. Today's applications, which are cloud-native applications, these are applications which are deployed on cloud, and we don't want to have any downtime between the application upgrades. So let's say we have one version of the application and a new version is getting rolled out. Unlike old days where we had to take down the servers, we had to bring down the application, then deploy the new version of the application. Nowadays, we do this in a very fast manner where the application doesn't require any downtime. One such strategy which is used for upgrading the application is called as a rolling update strategy. This strategy is part of the built-in Kubernetes deployment, which is a higher level construct, and it is supported by default. We don't have to do anything extra in terms of supporting this strategy. So let's look at what the rolling update strategy is and how we can apply it to our own applications. So here is a quick diagram depicting how the rolling update strategy works. We have the desired state of the application, and what the Kubernetes controllers does is it checks to see if the application is in the desired state. If not, it will go and select a pod, a older pod, and try to update it. But before updating, it will deactivate the old pod and it will create a new pod. And then it will continue this process until all the instances of the application are updated. So one of the prerequisites for rolling update strategy is it should have multiple replicas of the current version of the application. So for this demo, I'm going to use one of my existing application which I use in other demonstrations. This is called as the TechTalks, and it has a RabbitMQ producer component and a consumer component. So we are going to use only one of this to keep the demo simple. Now I have a TechTalks producer Docker container image which has got different tags. So we can consider these tags as different versions, and I've published these versions to the Azure Container Registry or ACR. So I have RabbitMQ-KEDA-5.0 as well as RabbitMQ-KEDA-6.0, and there is a dapper tag. So let's start with deploying this application, one version of this application. So I will use a Kubernetes deployment manifest file to deploy this. So it follows a standard pattern of having the API version kind as deployment, then providing some metadata like the name and the labels. And in the specification for the deployment, we specify 20 replicas. So we are going to have 20 instances of this RabbitMQ producer running in our Kubernetes cluster. And I will be using Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS cluster to deploy this particular application, the producer. And then we have different metadata related to this particular deployment. One thing to note here is currently the image that we are using is the RabbitMQ KEDA 5.0 tag for the TechTalks producer. I will not go through the remaining sections of this manifest file. If you want, you can go through that. I will provide the link to the GitHub repository. So let's get started. And using the kubectl command line tool, we will go and apply this particular manifest file, which will create the producer deployment, and it will create the instances for our application. So I'll create a watch here for the Kubernetes pods which are created. So on the left hand side, we will run this kubectl get pods with the watch flag, and we will also look at the deployments. So in the kubectl get deploy, we will watch this. So you can see that currently we have two deployments. One is related to the consumer, which is not having any replicas ready. And then in the pod side, if we rerun that command kubectl get pods with watch, we have 20 pods which are related to the producer deployment, and all of them are up and running. And these were created about 30 seconds ago. So with that, we have the first version of the application up and running. Now, if we look at this from a visual UI, I also use Lens sometimes to visualize the state of the Kubernetes cluster. We can find the same information regarding the deployment that we just did. So if I click on the RabbitMQ producer deployment, we can see that in the replicas, we have desired as 20, and all the 20 are updated. and all 20 are available. And the strategy that is currently applied is rolling update. So by default, even if we don't specify the strategy, then the Kubernetes, when it deploys or creates a type of deployment, it will apply the rolling update strategy. Now, if you want to customize this, we can customize some of the values. But before we go and customize, let's go and look at the default values for this rolling update strategy. So let me clear the screen here and describe this particular deployment. So I will run this command kubectl describe, then the name of the deployment or the type of the deployment, which is deploy, short form for deployment, and then the name of the deployment is RabbitMQ producer deployment. So this will give us all the details related to this particular deployment. So here we can see that it is using the default namespace. It has some labels and it shows the same number of replicas what we saw in the lens UI. And the strategy that it is using is rolling update strategy with 25% max unavailable and 25% max surge as the values which are set for this particular deployment by default. What this means is when we apply a new version of the image for this deployment, RabbitMQ producer deployment, it is going to apply a maximum surge of 25%. So in our case, we have 20 replicas running. So 25% of these replicas, so 4 replicas will be made unavailable, and the surge is it will try to increase maximum by 4 replicas. So that is how we can control the number of instances which are getting upgraded and replaced one at a time or as a batch in one single operation. So let's go and modify some of these. The first thing I want to do is, since I want to create a new version of this particular application, so I'm going to upgrade from the current RabbitMQ CADA 5.0 to use the image as RabbitMQ CADA 6.0, which is the next version of the application. And then I'm also going to override some of the settings related to the rolling update strategy. So I'll uncomment these lines from line number 13 to 17, and we specify the strategy as rolling update. The alternative for rolling update is recreate, in which case all the instances or all the replicas of this application will be recreated at one go. We don't want that. We want that progressively the application is deployed, the next version, so that there is no impact on the consumers and they don't feel the downtime. So in the rolling update strategy itself, we specify the max surge as 20. We override the default, which is 25% to 20, so that only 20% of the pods are increased one at a time or in a batch of objects. And also when it replaces the existing pods, when it makes the old version of the pod unavailable, we want to make sure that only 20% of the pods are made unavailable. This reduces the impact on the application or the end user. So if something goes wrong, they still have rest of the 80% of the application replicas running and they will not feel the impact of the upgrade if there is any problem with this. So with this, let's save these changes and let's go back and apply this to our deployment. So let's clear the screen here and let's go and run that apply command again to apply these changes. So instead of describe, we are going to use kubectl apply, and we provide the file name, which is the producer deployment.yaml file. Once we make this change, I want to have a quick look at the watchers. So we can see that it is changing the number of pods. We were watching both the pod and the deployment. So we see a series of pods have started terminating, and then it goes through the life cycle of the pod where they get in the pending stage and the new pods are created. So we see that here at one stage there are 4 pods which are terminating. Instead of making like more than one pod or 25% of the pod, because we overrid that setting, we have overridden the setting to say 20%. So 20% of our application is like 1/5, which is the 4 pods which are going to be terminated, and then it starts to create new pods and it starts to replace the pods. We can also see this in the deployment side of things. So if I scroll up here, as and when they get ready. So you see initially we had the 20 replicas ready for the producer deployment, and then we ran the update or we applied the new manifest. It went from, this is where it starts to reduce. So from the 20 up to date, it makes them zero and keeps 16 as available, and then starts to progressively implement the 20% rule, where 4 pods are made available of the new version, then it goes to 8. Then at the same time, the number of available pods, they start changing, and this increases. That is, the new version, which is represented by up to date, goes from 4 to 8, 8 to 9, 10, and the same way, the number of available pods, because the old version of the pods have to be made deactive and the new version of the pods have to be activated, they also go from 16 to 17, and then at one point they all become 20. So the new version is upgraded. All the 20 pods of the old version, which is 5.0 version, have been replaced with all the pods with 6.0. So this way we can manage how the progression happens for our application from one version to another. We can also see this in the UI. So if we go back and we look at the RabbitMQ producer deployment details, here we can see the amount of resources it's taking and how much time it took, but also in terms of the events, how it scales down to 14, then 10, and then it starts to scale up as well. So at some point we see that the replicas are now updating to 8 and then to 20. So this way progressively it applies the changes from old to new version. So I hope that you found this useful. If you want to see these changes, instead of applying the file or the whole manifest, we can also run a command line tool, or we can make these changes from the command line itself using the set. So there is a command which is called kubectl set. This can be used to set the image directly. So instead of applying the file, kubectl file, we can also make the change to the image version or the tag of the image which is used. And let's say I want to revert it back to the 5.0 version. So I can make this change as well. And this again, we would be able to see in the UI that the changes are happening. You can see here the number of pods which are ready, they go to 16, and 24 are the available pods. And we can see how progressively they change the numbers from how many are available to how many are ready. So with that, I think you get the idea of how to apply the progressive delivery technique of using this type of the deployment, which is the rolling update. And we can make sure that there is no downtime in the application. When the application upgrade happens, this can be a very seamless process. So I hope you found this useful. In case you find this video useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. Thanks for watching this video once again.